अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज मिस्टर जावेद अहमद शाह एंड माय रोल नंबर इज EP1770108 एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज मॉरिस वाटरमेस एक्सपेरिमेंट। टुडे आई हैव बीन गिवन दिस टॉपिक एंड द पोर्शन व्हिच आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस विद यू इज द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मॉरिस वाटरमेस एक्सपेरिमेंट। सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज मॉरिस वाटरमेस एक्सपेरिमेंट? इट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट वाइडली यूज्ड स्टडी एक्सपेरिमेंट फॉर द स्पेशल मेमोरी एंड द लर्निंग प्रोसीजर्स इन एनिमल्स। Animals are basically placed in a pool of water that is colored with non-fat milk or non-toxic tempera paint that is used to make this water opaque. In the midst of this, the animals lose their visibility due to the opaqueness of the water. So as the water is made opaque, the animals couldn't see properly, and then there is a platform present in between that water pool. And the animals are required to find that pool. So due to the absence of improper visibility, they cannot rely on their scent to find the escape route. Instead, they must rely on their external extra maze clues. Since the animals become more familiar with the task, then they are easily able to find the platform more quickly and more frequently. As the name suggests, this was developed by Richard G. Morris in 1984. And nowadays, this paradigm has become one of the gold standards of behavioral neuroscience. As we can see over here, this is a platform which has been divided into four equal quadrants. And then during training, when you are placing the rats in the different quadrant, like one rat is present over here, one rat is present over here, and one is here, and one is here. So before they are being trained, the rat shows movement like this. Some irregular movements, but after training, there is a kind of a symmetry in their movement. So basically, this experiment is used to deal with the behavioral neuroscience of the animals. And in the midst of this, we can find different neuroscience mechanisms and other things. Now I move towards my research article, and the topic which I have chosen for giving presentation is evidences for a paradoxical sleep window for place learning in Morris water maze. So as the topic suggests, first we have to understand that what is basically place learning. Place learning is basically a learning of location and positions. It helps us to store the information of the locations and the positions. So during this research article, the researchers, which are Carol Smith and Gregory Ambrose, basically found out some irregular behavior or interesting behaviors of rat, which was observed during this experimentation. And after that, this research article was concluded. So there was evidence for paradoxical sleep window for place learning in water forest ways. So what is basically this paradoxical sleep? When we are talking about sleep, there are majorly four stages of sleep, that is N1, N2, N3, and the last one is REM, or rapid eye movement, or we can also call it paradoxical sleep. So REM is characterized as the last stage of sleep that basically involves the muscle tone dropping to the lowest and muscles becoming paralyzed, while only the muscles of our eye and diaphragm remain normal. This action is basically carried out in pons virali. Pons are responsible for turning off the signals of the muscles, making them paralyzed. There are kind of waves that are known as PGO waves. These PGO waves are emitted during the REM and help us to see our dreams. So when we are in the condition of REM or paradoxical sleep, we are actually able to see or visualize our dreams. And we are more in a conscious state of mind when we are experiencing our dreams. On the other hand, the stress hormones are also absent during this stage of sleep. Even though REM sleep originate in pons virali, it causes the muscle paralysis. And this is specifically known as REM atonia, or rapid eye movement atonia. Atonia stands for muscle paralysis, and this is a specific or special muscle paralysis that is associated with the rapid eye movement. However, we need to understand that these are some of the established facts, but Nowadays, particular influence has been put upon the involvement of rapid eye movement sleep on the processing of memory. So we can easily call off that REM is also somewhere related with the processing of memory. Learning and memory. This is one of the important things that we need to understand. So what is basically learning and memory? In rats, it has been long known that the hippocampal theta rhythm is present during paradoxical sleep. So the theta rhythm is a specific kind of rhythm that is present in the rats, and due to the loss of hippocampal theta rhythm that is associated especially with the spatial memory or the positional memory that we have studied now, that spatial memory is basically associated with the memory of the positions and location. So as the hippocampal theta rhythm is reduced, so the spatial memory deficit also occurs in the rats. But before moving on to the experimentation, that what kind of experiment did the researchers conduct, and on the basis of that they conducted this following conclusion, we need to understand that what is learning and memory. So learning and memory are often described in terms of three functions. Acquisition, that is the induction of new information into our brain. The second one is consolidation, which is the process of memory becoming stable. So basically your brain memorized whatever it memorized, it make that information stabilize in our brain. And the last one is recall, or the third one is recall. This means that it is the ability of the brain or the ability of the memory to recall your information once again. While memory consolidation take place during our sleep, so the memory consolidation, the second type of second function of memory, is usually associated with sleep. But the other two memories are often occur in the form of wakefulness. So when we are awake, then the other two functions of memory are processing. But strangely, the rapid eye movement sleep play important role in acquisition of learned material. So the experimenters conducted three following experiments to develop some established facts upon that, and they conducted their experiment to establish a hypothesis that we are going to study right now. So now we'll go towards the experiment, and that is the experiment number one. So what is basically called an experiment number one? So we need to understand that, right? So the experiment number one was performed to determine that whether there was a presence of paradoxical sleep window that was present any time during the 24 hour in the daily training in the hidden platform version of water maze. So there was a version of water maze that was used in this experiment that was known as a hidden platform. So we'll study in detail that what is that hidden platform. Before moving in that, we will see the method of performance. So how does this experiment was performed? So there was Prague Broly rats that were taken at the Trent University that were at the age of 6 to 7 months. And these animals were used for that experiment. And the apparatus for this experiment was a water tank, which was filled to the depth of approximately 60 centimeter and was made opaque once again. Like we talked before, it was made opaque by the adding of non-toxic powder that was normally used to make watercolor paint. So the platform was inverted as a flower part with an 8.5 centimeter diameter base that was placed in between that water tank. So then the rat was allowed to sit on that water base on which it has to rest, but that platform was completely hidden from view since it was 2 centimeter under the surface of the water and attached with a solid frame. So there was a lack of visibility for the rats to see that platform. So after being placed in that water tank, they have to locate the exact location of the flower pot on the basis of their spatial memory. So when we are moving in excess detail, the area of the tank was divided into 4 equal quadrants, like I've told you before, indicated by markings on the side of the wall of the tank that they were not visible to the rat. So again, the visibility was reduced. The platform was always positioned in the center, like I've told you. The water in the tank was fresh each day. Now we have to be careful about this since we cannot compromise with the health of animals according to the health safety protocol. So the water has to be changed each day, and it has to be maintained at 23 to 24 degrees centigrade, and these were made as a constants. So now we have know about all the apparatus. Now we are moving towards the procedure. So prior to the starting of the experiments, the animal was handled for 5 consecutive days, at each spending at 10 minutes per day. So on the first day of the task, the rats were placed in a water tank on the above of a hidden platform, and they were remain stable over there or steadied over there until they stayed by themselves for at least 10 seconds. So they were placed on the water pot for at least, or the platform for the at least 10 seconds. And then they were released in the tank, and they were given 2 minutes in tank that they were allowed to stay on the platform, or they have to swim and they have to locate the position. But if the rat left the platform and it did not return for in the span of 2 minutes, so it is the responsibility of the experimenter to guide back that animal back to the platform and let that rat rest there for at least 15 seconds before returning that rat to the home cage. So we will have to return that rat to the platform. So in its spatial memory, it stored the information or the spatial memory or the position location of that platform. After that, if the rat did not find the platform after 60 seconds, the animal was guided to it. So this was the procedure of the experiment. Now we are moving towards the group. So the rats were divided in basically three major groups. So the experiment, as we know, that experiment was designed to see that if there is a presence of paradoxical sleep and deprivation. So now we are moving towards another term, which is PSD, paradoxical sleep deprivation. So what we are doing in these three experiments, we have to deprive the rats of the paradoxical sleep occurring sometime in the first 24 hours. So as the rats are deprived of their paradoxical sleep or REM sleep, and we have to then observe the results that what happened due to the deprivation of the paradoxical sleep. So the three groups are group 1 to 12. We can take that group 1 to 12 as group 1. So what does happen in this group 1? That the animals in this group are placed on the inverted flower pots of 8.5 centimeter diameter that was earlier discussed. And then there was enough room for them to rest comfortably. And as the rats sit on that inverted platform, they were engaged in slow wave sleep. It is a kind of sleep, we'll not go into detail of that sleep, but it is a kind of a sleep that is called as SWS or slow wave sleep. But as they are fast asleep on the platform, the complete muscular relaxation accompanying initiation of paradoxical sleep. So as the stage of paradoxical sleep is achieved in the rats, so they lose their consciousness and they fall down into the water. And then they suddenly wake up, and after a brief period of swimming, the animals are once again climb back on the flower pot. So this was the first group that was taken. The second group, which is group 13 to 24, GR 13 to 24, these animals were again placed in the home cages for 12 hours after the end of the last training time. Now there's a difference that these animals were placed in their home cages after 12 hours after the end of the training. And then they were placed in the PSD apparatus. So basically then the rats were placed in the PSD apparatus for the period of 13 to 24 hours after the last training trial. Now we have to see what is this PSD apparatus I'm talking over here. So let's see what is PSD. So now this is the PSD apparatus, paradoxical sleep deprivation apparatus. So in this apparatus, when the rats are placed, they are deprived of their paradoxical sleep. Since there is a small thing which is moving inside this apparatus. So as it goes on and touch the rats are deprived of their sleep. So they are not allowed to sleep like this rat, which was maybe resting and which may have gone into the stage of paradoxical sleep. But due to the movement of this slit, the rat are not allowed to sleep and they are deprived of their sleep. So this is basically paradoxical sleep apparatus. So now we have understand the second group. The last group is control group, that this group was never placed in the PSD apparatus. So the second group was placed in the PSD apparatus, like we have told you before, but the third wasn't placed in the PSD apparatus. So as the results indicate, the ANOVA for three groups over four training days revealed a significant repeated variable effect. So it indicated that all the groups exhibited substantial reduction in their time to find the platform over training. So as the experiment progressed and the experiment and the result were found to be that all the animals show reduction in the time to find the platform, while the rate of the learning between the different groups were also different. But apart from that, the Newman Cules comparison also revealed that the group GR12 or the first group that we took significantly longer time to find the platform, and this impairment especially occurred on the training of the day two. So as indicated in this graph, you can see the mean time to find the platform. So as we see the group one or GR112. So when we look onto this is indicated by the black mark, we see a unusual behavior over here, as the animal took some time longer on the second day to find that platform. But when we are talking about the other groups, that it moves with a specific symmetry, and it moves in a symmetry of reduction. With each passing day, it reduces. In the second, third case of control, it also was the same case. But when we are talking about this specific case, there was a specific increase. There was a specific increase on the second day, and then the usual behavior was observed. So this was a clear indication that the PSW was present in this experiment. So experiment number 2 was conducted to confirm that what was the precise time of the PSW, when was it manifested in the rats. So paradoxical sleep window was manifested. That was quite assured from that experiment number 1. Now we have to indicate the precision of the time when it initiated. So again, 3 groups were taken in this. And the first group is group 1 to 4. We can call it group 1. Then the group 2, group GR 5 to 8. And then GR 9 to 12, we can call it group 3. So the group was given 4 hours of paradoxical sleep. The first group was given 4 hours of paradoxical sleep deprivation, starting immediately after the last training trial. So as the training trial ended, they were given 4 hours of PSD in the apparatus. So soon after the training. And in the second case, it was returned to the home cage soon after the training. But after the presence of at least 4 hours, they were again placed in the paradoxical sleep deprivation apparatus. And in the case of the third group, they were again placed into the home cages immediately after the last training. But in this case, they were placed 9 hours after the training into the PSD apparatus. So there's a bit of difference. Here they are immediately placed, here they are placed after 4 hours, and here they are placed after 9 hours. So these 3 groups were present. And when the result came, it seemed some different results. So the ANOVA revealed that there was a substantial learning in all of the groups. So there was a substantial changes in the learning procedure of the rats, that Newman-Kuhl's comparison basically revealed that group 5 to 8 took significantly longer to find the platform on the training day 2. Again, the second group took longer to find the platform on the day 2. So the same result as we observe over there, second group took some longer time. Over here, again, the second group took some longer time on the day 2 to find the platform. Newman-Kuhl's test showed that the second group had more goal quadrant entries either than group 1 to 4 or 9 to 12 on training day 2. Now, this is interesting, that it indicates that there is more goal entries. It means that on second day, they were not able to reach the platform, and there was a significant time that they took to find the platform, but there were more goal entries in the second day when the rats were trying to find the platform. So this is something interesting. So on the basis of this experiment, here we can see over here the goal quadrant entries, like the experiment number 2, group 1, 2, and 3 I have mentioned over here before. Here is some, everything follows a particular symmetry, but over here in the case of the second group, second day, goal quadrant entries increase suspiciously when comparing with the other groups. Like here we can observe a clear decrease. Over here we can observe a clear decrease, but over here there was an unusual increase at the day 2 of experiment number 2. So on the basis of that, we have confirmed that there is a specific role of paradoxical sleep in our spatial memory. And if we are depriving the rats of the paradoxical sleep, so the spatial memory is affected. So in order to confirm that result, the last experiment was concluded, and that was experiment number 3. In this, the water maze problem was modified into a visible water maze, where basically the platform was placed 2 centimeters above the level of the water. In addition to the top of platform was not covered with beach tape as well. So the dark color of the inverted flower pot was also visible for the rats, so the rats can easily find that group. Again, these rats were placed in 3 groups. The first group, in this, the rats were given the trial each day, like the groups over in the other experiment. Then they were placed in the PSD apparatus for the 12 hours. Following this, they were returned to the home cage until the following day. The paradoxical sleep to be involved in learning. So this was the first group. And when we are talking about the second group, These rats were also allowed 12 hours of rest in their home cages, and then they were placed in PSD apparatus for at least 12 hours. So, and the third one is again the control group that were not trained in the cue tasks either, but they returned to home cages with the following day. So the control were never exposed to the paradoxical sleep deprivation apparatus, while the other two groups were exposed to the paradoxical sleep deprivation apparatus. The group two was at least placed in that paradoxical sleep apparatus, deprivation apparatus for 12 hours after the 12-hour rest. And while in the case of the first group, they were placed immediately. But the results show that the visible platform experiment revealed that there was significant involvement in time to reach the goal of the all groups during the day four regime training. This result basically indicates that PSD did not affect the learning of either treatment group. So here, the paradoxical sleep deprivation is not affecting any kind of movement of the rat. So the rat were easily able to find that platform, even though they were deprived of their paradoxical sleep. So this also can confirm that it is possible that the learning of the hidden platform tasks involve the sequential activation of several brain structures, only the first of which require PS-related activity for normal function. So it is an established fact, as we know, that the hippocampal formation plays a critical role in place learning. So we can easily conclude that paradoxical sleep deprivation is majorly playing its role in the place learning or spatial memory, not in other forms of memory. So if you are awake and you are seeing something in front of you, you can easily locate, even though you are deprived of your paradoxical sleep cycle. But if you are not, but if something isn't visible to you and you are then asked to find that location and you are deprived of paradoxical sleep, maybe your functions could get disturbed or distracted by that. So there can be many arguments. The stress can be a contributing factor for this and other kind of things. But we have to see that whether they are important or not. But for the sake of this research article, it was enoughly evident that these paradoxical sleep deprivation experiment caused the rat to lose their ability of spatial memory. So we can easily conclude on the basis of this experiment that paradoxical sleep play important role in the spatial memory or the learning memory for the positions and the locations. So the result from experiment 2 indicated that the most vulnerable time period for PSD induced acquisition deficit was 5 to 8 hours. This was the confirmed time that at this time, after the end of last training trial, the acquisition deficit occurred basically. So acquisition, like we have talked before, the induction of new information in brain. So at this time, the induction of new information was affected in our brain. So this was the whole concept of this research article. And here I would like to conclude with these last statements, which basically say that this work indicates the selective period of PSD retard spatial learning in Morris water maze. In contrast, PSD has no effect upon the non-spatial version, as confirmed by the experiment number 3. That if there is a non-spatial version, then you don't have to use your spatial memory for finding anything. So PSD isn't affecting the non-spatial version of the water maze. So taken together, these results suggest that the hippocampus may be important site for PSD action. That hippocampus in your brain is an important site for the PSD action. So this is the most important point of this research article, and they concluded their experiment over there. So I would like to conclude my research article presentation over here. Thank you so much for listening. Assalamu alaikum.